Hey there, it's Carla Lynn Hall from InternetFamousVIP.com, and I teach bloggers how to create and sell digital products. Hello, it is Friday, May 25th, and it is May is for marketing. So each day or nearly near daily, I'm doing near daily live streams on my Facebook page to teach you how to sell your digital products. I'm coming with a different tip every day. And you see that heart over there? That the heart with feet. I just realized it's always on that wall and you can't really see what it is. But it's a heart with feet and legs. And my niece made it for me. Well, she gave it to me for Valentine's Day, and I think it's really cute. Anyway, so today's tip. Today's tip is a simple one. And actually, you don't even have to have a digital product in order to do this. But it really helps to be an authority. So when you have a digital product, and that's an ebook or an online course or a PDF printable, you've taken your knowledge or expertise and you have created something that someone else can use. In the quick case of like sheet music or a lesson plan, someone else is using something that you created and you put it into a digital form. Now, once you do this, you are an authority. So one of the things that you could do, and today's tip is for you to write guest blog posts. Now, if you're already a blogger, you know how to write blog posts. But you can take your blogs, your content, and showcase it on someone else's blog. Perhaps someone else in your own niche that has like a larger following, and you could write something for this other blog, and in exchange, you don't get payment, but you get a link back to your website, and maybe you talk about your product, or maybe you have like a author's bio at the end of your blog post that gives a little biography of who you are, talks about what product that you sell, and links to your website or to your product, whatever that is. That is really that's great advertising, and it's for free, when you blog for someone else. Now, so if you are interested in doing something like that, I suggest that you check out the other blogs in your niche and see which ones are open to guest blogs. And because not everyone is, but the thing is, most of us who have blogs, we know that we're constantly having to create new content. So it also you're also doing the other person a favor by guest blogging because you are creating content for them that they didn't have to create. So, and there's like, there's a bit of a win-win situation there. So if you find someone in your niche who would be open, you check out their like about page or contact page, and you also just look at the blog itself and you make sure that they've had guest bloggers before. So, and if they have, then there's probably some kind of contact sheet, contact form that, or there might even be something that says how to write a guest blog. Some blogs are very open to it. So look at the blog and see that they have openings for guest bloggers. So then the other thing you want to think about are the niches. Now you don't have to use your own niche. So for example, Charlotte is a beekeeper, so she can do guest blogs for other beekeeping blogs. So other people who have blogs, she can submit an article and get a link back to her own website or her online course or ebook, because she's got a lot going on, that beekeeper Charlotte. But she can also go to niches that are similar. So for example, beekeeper Charlotte could do blog posts for a survivalist niche. Like that's really popular. I mean, the people who are off the grid, they are into nature, but that doesn't mean that they wouldn't be interested in keeping bees. They might be very interested in bees. Or she could write something. She could blog about something that they might want to know about that could help them. So, there's definitely some synergy there. Or also gardeners. She could also write a blog post on a gardening blog and talk about, pollen or whatever bees and plants do that's so, wonderful and magical, and why bees and gardeners need each other. So there's a lot of synergy there. So similar for you, you think about your own niche and think about other similar niches where you might be able to do a good blog posts. You might be a good guest blogger. So you can go for someone a little higher than yourself, you know, someone whose blog gets more views than yours. And like I said, you're providing content for them. And you let people know that, you know, you were interested in submitting a guest blog, perhaps link to some samples and see what happens, you know, and you could, you know, contact a few at a time and see and make them, you know, the best articles that you can be. Don't skimp on quality. And you know how to write blogs. You know, most of you are already established bloggers. So think about writing on someone else's blog and promoting your digital product. That is a great way to promote your digital product so that excuse me, it's a great way to promote your digital product and people know about you, and that's just, you know, 24 hours. It's just another link back to your site. So there's a lot of goodness that can happen when you do guest blogs on someone else's site. Okay, so if you would like to get more tips, you can check out my new selling module from my online entrepreneur course. It is now a freebie. Check it out at internetfamousvip.com/sell. That's internetfamousvip.com/sell, SELL. I'm Carla Lynn Hall, and I will see you soon. Bye.